Need to build a website for your business? Today we're going to explore how to do that using Wix and some of its built-in AI tools. Let's dive in. To follow along, click the affiliate link in the description or in the top right corner. It helps support the channel. Thanks for clicking. And then to get started, we'll go ahead and select Get Started. Then we can sign up or log in here. I'll just continue with Google. We need to specify if we're creating a site for ourselves or a client, so we'll choose myself for this tutorial. Then we'll get a prompt for creating the backend of our site, known as the dashboard, with using AI chat or by using Wix's business templates. I'm going to show both options to show how they work, and I'll do the same thing for when we actually go to create the site as well. We'll start with the AI chat. So each of these answers to these prompts, I just fed the questions into ChatGPT and copy-pasted the answers back here. But essentially what this chat is looking for will be a number of questions to best suit how your site dashboard functions. So for example, you might get questions like, what is the name of your business? What type of website are you creating? What are the goals for your site? Who is your target audience? What functionality or integrations does your site need? And what other details about your business would be good to know? Once you've answered each question, it'll build an optimized dashboard for your business. Now let's try the other option and manually select the options for a website and what the site plans to offer. So let's do the setup without chat option. The first question will be about what type of store you have or what type of website you want to create. This is how Wix will decide what type of dashboard you need. So we're just going to type in dessert shop right here, click continue, and that will set up our dashboard. And once it loads, we'll get this prompt to start setting up our store so we can go ahead and enter our store name here. Click continue, and then it'll ask us if we have an online store already, so you can merge it with the site you're creating, or if you don't have one, we can just start from scratch. Hit continue, and then we'll get a couple prompts on what kind of products we're selling and what kind of stuff we offer in terms of how we sell our products. So we can just set up those and then click continue for both, and then go to our dashboard. And then once your dashboard loads, you'll get a prompt here on connect a custom domain, and it'll auto-populate it with what you've named your site, so you can hit let's go to see if that domain is available. And if it is, then you can use that as your site name when you go to purchase the domain. Now we'll get to this in a little while, but because we set up our dashboard the way that we did, Wix has already populated some things that we might need for the type of site that we created, which is really nice. But let's just go ahead and actually go to design our site now, so we can go up to this icon right here and go to design site, and it's going to ask us if we want to generate a design with AI or customize a template. Just like before, we'll try the AI version first. Now this is using the AI dashboard I created earlier, so that's where it's getting the information from to generate the results. Now once a site is generated, we have a few options. If we think the AI completely flunked, like the first time I ever tried to skateboard, then we can have it try to completely regenerate the design. Or if we mostly like it but it doesn't feel quite right, then we can select tweak design. And that'll give mostly the same feel, but with a different layout. And once we like it, we can continue with this design and go to the editor. Now to show the templated version on the design site page, we'll select pick a template. And just to clarify, this design is based off the templated dashboard, not the AI one. Now this page will show numerous presets we can use to build our site from based on the style of site that we're creating. Just keep in mind that once you choose a template, you can't go back and change it unless you're rebuilding the site from scratch. Now we can check out a preview of any of these presets by selecting View so we can see how they look by default. And if we like the template, we can either select Edit this site from here, or we can go back to the list to ensure that this is the template we want to use. And if so, we can hover over it and select Edit. And that'll take us to the actual site editor. Now when you first open the site editor, you'll probably get this prompt that says enhance your AI content. What we can do is we can just add a little more details about the site, and that'll help customize some of the text that goes on all the pages. So we can just use that and generate site text, and that'll change some of the default text on the site to something that is more catered to what we're building for. So just to give a quick overview of how sites are built, let's just go ahead and zoom into 100% so we can see this better. Now the first thing we want to look at in our site is our header. And the header is the central hub for where your navigation bar is, and this is where you can navigate to different pages on your site. You can also have different links to different social media accounts. You can have the title of your website, and maybe some other links for searching through your site, some profile information, or shopping carts, depending on what type of site you have. And each of your website pages is divided up into sections. So if we scroll down, we'll see that we have different broken up sections of our website here. So maybe you have some stuff for the overview of what your site is about. You have some featured pictures or desserts in this case, or any other kind of separate section that you might want to have. And then if we go to the bottom of any of our pages, we'll have what's called the footer. And footers are typically used for additional links that aren't in your navigation bar. So this could be your about page, frequently asked questions, contact information. And then in this case, we have some hours for when the store is open, an address, submitting newsletter information with emails, and some more social media links as well. And then the last thing to be aware of on almost any given page is you can have external apps or extensions that allow you to do things like add a chat box, more contact info, add forms, whatever you may want. To modify any of our existing sections, we can just go to any of them and then hover over Quick Edit, and that'll bring up the Content Box tab where we can edit the background of our section and any of the media that's inside of this section, so any pictures or any other videos or GIFs that we might have inside of our section. And then we can edit the title and maybe any buttons that may exist in our section as well. Now, if we wanted to edit elements more specifically, we can go ahead and close out this quick edit here, and we can select those elements individually. So for example, we'll select this text here, and then we can edit text. And now we have a lot more options as to how we can edit this text. So let's just change the font here to something else. And we can change our font size so it doesn't overlap the photo. And there's a lot more things we can do, like adding effects to it as well if we wanted to add a bit of drop shadow to add a little bit more of a 3D effect to our text. And then if we select our button here, we can change the text inside of our button, but we also have different things like changing the layout of the button. We can change the design of the button. We can add animation to it depending on how we want it to show up. And then change to where that button links to. And we have a number of options of where this button can link to, like a different page on our site, a different web address entirely, a different section on either the same page or a different page, to different files, emails, phone number, pop-ups, whatever you'd like. So there's a lot of options with buttons. So those are a lot of the options we have to change settings and elements on the page itself, but let's go ahead and go over to our side navigational bar over here. The first tab we have here is our Add Elements button, and this will allow us to add text, images, buttons, strips, or any other type of individual element that we want to insert into a page or a section. Then we have our Sections tab, and the Sections tab allows us to add in new sections inside of our individual pages. If we want to add, let's say, a new welcome section, we can just click and drag a section template into any part of this page, and it'll automatically shift any other sections accordingly. So we can just drop this in on the page, and now we've added a new section. And then we can fully customize this section however we want. So we can go inside of this text. And another nice thing that I haven't really shown yet is we can actually generate new text with AI in the individual text box itself. So let's go ahead and do that. And I'm just going to go ahead and put in what type of text I need here. We can go ahead and generate this. And then once it generates, we can select Use Text, and it'll automatically replace the text inside of our text box. Another thing you can do is you can do AI tools, and this will allow us to either rewrite our text, make it shorter, so maybe this is a little bit too long. I can select this, and it'll automatically rewrite the text. And then I can use it, and now it's shortened it while getting the same matches across. Now, some of you that are a little OCD might be screaming at this point, so let me go ahead and fix that for you. You're welcome. Just kidding. Let me fix that again. But of course, with our new section, we still have the ability to increase or decrease the height of it, move it at any point, and swap it with other sections. And I can go ahead and zoom out to 50%. And that'll make it much easier for us to see where it's being moved to. If you want to delete a section for whatever reason, we can go to More Actions and then select Delete. And if that section has apps inside of it, it'll automatically delete those apps as well. The next tab we want to look at is our Pages and Menu tab. And this is essentially your central hub for everything navigationally, hopefully that's a word, to anything on your site. So a quick overview here, we have the ability, of course, to add new pages, to delete existing ones, and to specify which pages we want to show up in our header bar, or which ones we want to exist, but maybe have a different way of navigating to them, like extra text links or buttons or however you want to navigate to them. Now you can add or take away pages from the menu bar simply by just going to this drop-down menu and either going Show in Menu or by going to hide from menu, and that'll add it and take it away from the header bar respectively. You can also reorder your pages simply by just clicking and dragging, and that'll reorder them either in the menu bar or however they show up inside of our site menu here. Or you can click and drag the page to the right and it'll create this little drop down option. So now if we take a look at our About Me, and I'm just going to select Preview so that I can look and see what our site looks like. If I hover over About Me, you'll see that it creates a drop down for contact. Now we don't necessarily want this, so I'm just going to go back to the editor, bring up our pages and menu, and I'm just going to drag it to the left to take it off of the dropdown. Now these links don't necessarily have to link to a different page. So for example, if we wanted to add a menu item, we'll see we have different types of pages we can add here, but a simple one is just navigating to a different section. So if I just add a section into here, we can select what page that section is on and then which section we want to navigate to. So let's say we want to go directly to the products, but products isn't its own page, it's a section on a different page. So we can hit done and now hit done again to navigate to products. And now if we preview and look at our products, it'll navigate directly to our products section on our home page. Let's go ahead back to the editor again. Or to navigate to a specific point, not necessarily a specific section, we can select anchor. And then where on the page, we can just select add new anchor, and that'll add this point here to specify where on the page specifically we want this to link to. So let's just go ahead and type in inspiration, and then we can click and drag this down so that it goes right below our section here to go to the inspiration section. So anytime this anchor is clicked, the anchor will signify the top of the page. And then if we go to our pages and menu, and then we can rename this anchor to inspiration once again. And now it'll show up that way in the header bar. So let's go to the preview. And if we scroll up, we can see the inspiration is here. And once we click on it, it'll take us right down to the inspiration section. So let's go ahead back to editor. And I'll go ahead and remove that inspiration anchor for now. Now let's look at what adding a whole entire new page looks like. So we can just go to add page. Both the add page and this add new page icon are the same. So we can go here and we can choose based on other templates for types of pages. So let's say we want to add a projects page to kind of showcase how we make our stuff. So let's just go ahead and choose from one of these. I like this one here in particular. You can always preview to see what that page looks like. And if you like it, we can select add page, and that'll add our page into our page menu. I'll go ahead and rename this page to our work, and we can navigate through our page just like normal to see what all we have to do with it. Now let's say we wanted to start adding our own custom photos or videos inside of our site. We can actually navigate to this media tab here, and this will allow us to either upload directly from another website or upload stuff ourselves. Now I can either select upload from computer and navigate to the files from there, or I can just click and drag the file itself into our media bin, and that's going to upload my Tim's Tasty Treats logo. There's another interesting thing in here. We have the AI image creator. So we can go in here and describe what type of image that we want to create, what kind of style we want to use, or if there's not a specific style, we can just go with the text and hit create image. And if we wanted to reiterate it, we could change our text or style and hit create again. Or if we like what we have and we just want to use it, we can select use image, and I can change basic properties or add filters or different effects onto the image, but I'm just going to keep it as is and hit save. And now we have a delicious looking gluten-free cookie. There are multiple ways that we can add this to our pages. I'm just going to go ahead and close this out because I do want to add this to the home page. So let's go back over to our site menu. Go to home, and maybe I want to add that photo to this section here, but I need to reorganize how I have this section laid out. So let's just go ahead and click on this section, go to edit, and then we can go to our layout, and we want to move the layout a little bit so that we have the welcome on the left and the photo on the right. So let's just go ahead and choose this layout instead. And now if we go to the content, we can scroll down to where our image is, hit change. And then we can select our delicious gluten-free cookie and then select choose image. And now we have that image on our website. So that's how you can add and replace images. So let's go ahead and go over to our site design now, because we might want to change the template colors or the theme of our site based on what our store looks like. Now we can, of course, go and edit all of these individual elements of our theme, but let's go ahead and just check out this theme assistant here and see what kind of stuff we want to do with it. Now I want to change the colors, so I'm going to tell it to change colors. And I would like to base my color theme on the logo of the store. So let's go ahead and tell it to use the store logo. So I'm going to tell it to use the colors from the Tim's Tasty Treats logo, and as it runs through the prompt, it'll automatically open the tab to add and use our logo to generate a color theme using AI. So let's go ahead and select from the files that we have. We have already uploaded my logo here, so I'll select choose image, and now it's going to take a look at that image and then generate multiple color themes based on our logo. And we can go ahead and preview those, see what each of those look like. And maybe I want to keep this third one here, so we can just keep that theme and call it a day. Let's go ahead and close out our color theme and our assistant over here. And the last tab I just want to explore real quick is the Add Apps tab. This will be a great place to buy and download apps that help support your site. You can also manage the apps that you currently have downloaded and are using. And then something that's always good to check is this tab right here, where you can switch to the mobile version of the site to make sure everything displays properly. And layouts will typically be different on your mobile. But the other good thing about it is when you edit anything on the mobile side, it will not affect anything on your desktop. So let's just say I remove this section here and selected hide. If I go back to the desktop version, the desktop site will remain unchanged. And then anytime you feel like you've made a mistake, you can always undo a change that you've made. So this will undo hiding that section on the mobile site, and it'll take us to that page for the change. And of course we have redo in case we want to revert it back. And then whenever you're done making any of your changes, you can go ahead and hit publish, and that'll make your site official, and any changes that you've made to your site will officially be live for anybody to see. Now, if you haven't actually published your website yet before, there might be a few other setup settings that you need to finish. So let's go ahead and do that right now. And this will take us back to our dashboard. And the key thing that we want to make sure that we do is get this domain. So let's go ahead and hit let's go. And Tim Stacy Treats is available. Yay. So let's make it yours. And that'll take us to the purchasing page. You want to make sure that you do the premium plan, because the domain will not link your site to Wix. So let's go ahead and hit continue. And here you can choose which type of option you want to use for your site. If you are accepting any type of payments or you're selling anything on your store, you'll at least need to choose the core option so that you can run payments through your site. So we'll just go ahead and select business for now. Here you can choose your billing option. Select continue to checkout, and then complete your purchase option from here. And there you have it. Those are the fundamentals of how to create a website using Wix. If you'd like to explore Wix some more, there's an affiliate link down in the description. It helps support the channel. And please leave a comment or a like or whatever you decide to do down there, letting me know what you thought of this tutorial. And I hope to see you in the next one. Bye-bye.